G'day, this house is about to become a three-story. Watch my video, this is part two, on how to do the formwork. I want to show a cool trick here. So I know this ply is 1200 wide and the piece I need is 1100 wide. So I need to cut 100 mil off it. So rather get my tape and measure two ends and ping a line, what I can do is use these measurements on the saw. So the 10 is 100 mil. Hold my finger on the 10 and use it as a guide. And then just like that, I've cut 100 mil off. I've got 1100. It's going to fit where I need it to fit. So that's how you lay your sheets, cut in the ply. Now just rinse and repeat till the whole job's complete. One of the final things we have to do on these jobs, because they're brickwork houses, the concrete slab is going to bear on this brickwork. What we have to do is put a bond breaker in, because if the concrete sticks to that, when the temperature changes and we get expansion and contraction differences between the concrete and the brickwork, the concrete will basically grab the brickwork and shift it slightly, and you end up with big cracks in the walls. Especially if you ever see a brick house, it's got a concrete slab and you look at the top in the corners and there's cracks running down, it's from this. So what we do is put tin down, PGI. I'll just show you roughly how to do that. It has to be double layer to allow movement. Generally you shouldn't nail this, but these are pins, they'll move, they'll shift. So now that everything on the underside, the soffit, is complete, we now just have to form up whatever needs to be done on the top. So in this case, it's just some balcony stuff and rebates for glass on the balcony, and that's it. Now we just gotta wait for concrete.